Hey everybody, I'm so glad you're here. It's Mickey Mikeworth. And today, we're going to talk about the 12-week year and overwhelm. So, really common for week one and week two is about 30% of the people that come into group have never been here. They just saw somebody that their friend is like, man, you got to do this. And it sounded like such a good idea. If you are the person who went, oh gosh, I didn't even know there was a book. You are not alone. So the 12-week year accountability group is based on a book, The 12-Week Year. So you will want to read that. So if you didn't read it by week one, you'll need it read by week two. And the only reason that you have to read that book is so that you understand the foundational elements of what we're doing in accountability. So there is a ton of stuff. Now, first of all, I don't, we, this is a judgment-free zone that, my name is Mickey Mikeworth. I've dedicated my whole life to prosperity. We're not here to judge you. We're here to say what's up, right? Let's help you do the things that you want to do. For me, I've dedicated my life to prosperity mindset. And when we put the 12-week year with the prosperity mindset, we really get this beautiful piece of flow that makes it effortless to achieve a lot. So I want you to just kind of exhale. So if you're feeling overwhelmed, like I'm not doing it right, somebody's gonna ask me a question, I won't know the answer. No. If you just stay tuned in, you will do it. And I wrote myself a little note because I think what people come into this is they feel that they don't have a route, right? That you need a route for you. And that's what I'm going to talk about today. What is the route for you? Not what's the route for the book, not what's the route for everybody else, but we have to find the route for you. And sometimes that takes people a lot longer. This is 84 days of your life. So what happens when you're new to it? Well, you're looking for a route for yourself. So my first piece of advice is to just pick one goal. If you have never done something like this before, I would pick something that is more like a foundational goal. So a foundational goal is something that is a little more substantive, that's kind of just the opening, right? So a lot of times people are doing a health goal. They may have a project that's been sitting. I love this for a project. I love this for those of you who are working on your book, who are building a class, who are doing some, really foundational pieces that are easily measured. This is about a SMART goal. This is SMART goal on steroids. And it's also about six different things. The 12-week year is not like some invention that like some mastermind had. It is many concepts that have been pushed together to be formidable. It just is easy to digest. And a lot of people have done it. And the reason that it's easy to digest is you pick one goal. That's where you should start. And you want to look at that as a foundational goal. And that's the easiest place to start. And when you look at that one goal, now we're going to go, okay, well, let's write it. Let's write it down. Let's write down the goal. And we're going to write it down as a SMART goal, right? It's measurable. Right. So there's another video on SMART goal. So you're going to write down that one goal and then you're going to figure out how you're going to get that. And then we're going to break it down to every day and then you're going to manage it. And when you look at the 12-week year, why is it amazing? And why does everybody have to have a route to get in? Is because it's practiced behavior. This is practiced behavior. You have to learn how to get your goals done and how to do them every single day. So when you hear people talk about it, it's an execution model that you're just learning how to say, here's what I want. Here's a very small time that I can do. And it's 84 days. So if you've already had a week, it's only like 75 now. So it, no one that I've ever had that takes this class is set in week one. No one. So if you were set in week one, it means that you've probably done this before, or you're taking some goals from before and bringing them forward, or you've been doing something like this. But for the rest of us, just average humans, we're figuring it out in week one. we're just kind of going, what can I do? And there's an emotional route. I mean, this is what we have to find out. This is actually your journey, is to go, what is the correct route for you? Right now, 99% of the people that are coming in, they don't actually have a game plan for how to get to their goals. And what I love about 12-week year is it really helps people keep their promises to themselves. And that is the prosperity mindset. So I would, I get to keep the promises to myself. Now that feels different. That makes all of your planning and tactics look different. You can exhale, because we're just trying to find out what are the forms. You know, a lot of people, when they start coming in on a foundational goal, they haven't even measured their capital. They don't know what resources they have. They don't know what they're building off of. They don't know how to create balance. They don't know how to form their creativity into the right pattern. So remember, a foundational goal means that it's a vital goal. It's a vital to your life. So pick something to start out with that's foundational. It's rudimentary. It's really, it's something that you want hardwired into everything that you're doing. And a foundational goal is always the one to go back to. We see a lot of people who have a lot of stuff that are undone, and that's why so many people, are doing organizational stuff, because they need to set this somewhere. They need to go, oh yeah, right here is where I gotta go. If this is set, I'm good. So for many of you, your first round is a foundational goal. So pick one. And for those of you who are high achievers and you're like, I can't just pick one goal in this meeting. Okay, pick two. But one of them should be foundational. And for a foundational goal, lots of you are just learning what kind of capital you have and what you have in stock and trade, right? What do you have in stock and trade? What time do I have? What do I need to do? If I were going to look at where do I start, pick one goal. If you're an overachiever, pick two, make one foundational. The second place I start is with the calendar, is that grabbing that 3-hour chunk of time every single week. Every single week, you have to grab that 3 hours and block it off, that you're only going to work on your 12-week goals right there. That one is where everyone, until you master that, you will not master the 12-week year. So you must learn to say, I'm taking 3 hours, none of you are talking to me, and I'm going to work just on my own life. That, for every mompreneur, for everyone who has a crazy life already, for everyone who's ADHD, for everyone who is scattered everywhere, 3 hours is key. So if you want to give yourself a tool to get your life together, that's it. Then, so, right, pick a goal. If you're overachiever, pick two. Then pick one that's foundational. Then get your calendar. And you have to keep that calendar. And then out of that calendar, you're going to get one more hour. And that's the hour that I love to call the flake out hour, but it's like, when does your life flake out? Like, I had that 3 hours and like I had to, I have two aging parents. So like sometimes my 3 hours is spent taking them to ER, or, you know, managing some craziness in my life. So, we end up with stuff to do. So, when you think about what is it, that you need to do, right? And sometimes it is, you know, my heat was out, my dog barfed in the, you know, like, I mean, like, I got to take my dog to the vet. There are many things in my life personally that have eaten my 3 hours, but I have a 1 hour, like, Hail Mary pass. So you want to put your 3 hours in, and then you want to put in that extra hour of time. So that's where you just start with. So if you get that done this week, all right, you're really cooking. And I would put it in for every one of those 12 weeks. Go through your calendar right now and really say, these are my hours. Now, from a prosperity mindset, for those of you who have taken other classes, we talk about life force energy, right? We have a natural pattern. So put your 3 hours when you're awesome. That's the prosperity mindset. Put your 3 hours in at a time that you are amazing. So if you're a morning person, put it in the morning. If you're not a morning person, put it in a not morning time. But most people that take this class, because we do it on Sundays, most people are using that 3 hour block on Sunday that they're saying, look, I'm going to really get stuff together. And remember, tactics is agency. So now we're going to move to tactics. Tactics is the way of doing. So the next thing you got to get your head around is tactics, the way of doing. And the way of doing is agency. Now remember, agency is that I control this, that I feel like I can control my environment. I have agency over it. Oh, well, that's a lie I love to tell myself anyway. But if you have agency, it's to say, how, what's the way I'm going to do this? What's the mindset? What's the organizational tool? How am I going to get there? Right? So that's what we're talking about in tactics. And there are other videos for that. And tactics, if you just get them for the one goal, it's easier to understand and practice. And then you have tasks. And the tasks is where the scorecard is really coming from. Let me go get it again, right? So this is your weekly scorecard. So you're saying, look, here are the tactics, right? This is the way of doing. And this is how I get my credit for it. Now, many of you are going to have another sheet that has all the little tasks that you're going to be doing. And a lot of you are going to be learning how to batch tasks and things like that. But you're just looking to say, here are the tactics of how I'm going to do that. So a foundational goal may be around your health. So for me, this one of my tactics was move every day for 30 minutes. So I can just check mark off, did I move my body for 30 minutes every day? Okay. Sometimes a tactic is, right, if I'm trying to eat healthy, it's that I ate vegetables three times. If I ate a vegetable three times in one day, oh, you better believe that I am putting a little check mark there. You want these tactics to be things that say, look, if I just keep doing this, if I keep making the next right decision, and that's all it is, let me focus in on the right decisions. Everybody knows that diet and exercise will help you. But I have to find the route for me, and you will find the route for you. And that's what tactics are. So you are going to really come from someone who is unrouted into someone who is routed, that you can see the path, that you can move that way, that you've got the way in. And then you're going to do this scorecard. What this scorecard does for you in round one is it teaches you to do something every day. What it does for you is it keeps you accountable because you're going to come to class and you're going to say, hi, and we're all going to go, yay, or oh, or maybe you should change your tactic, or is that the right tactic for you? So that's why this is important. But for those of you who are going to pick this up for the rest of your life, because it is a tool to help you, right? Oh, let's stay calm. It's going to help you keep the promises to yourself. And why is that a big deal in prosperity? It's a big deal because, right, what are you learning? To hold the self in esteem, right? We are learning to hold the self in esteem. So from the prosperity mindset, that's part of what this does is it puts us first. And that's a great lesson. So we're going to talk a lot about tactics. So we're going to pick the one goal. If you're an overachiever, pick two. By this time in this video, that all of you have picked three, but I'm only expecting one foundational, right? Make it foundational. If you have two, then make one of them foundational. If you're going to do three, pick pick something because you got to get it on the scorecard. And having 10 extra tasks in a day, it's really time consuming. So also think of things that if you're going to push more than one thing forward, you know, sometimes those tactics should be like this, like the time that it takes you to brush your teeth. And you see, you hear me that like sing happy birthday three times, right? Happy birthday. That's my tactic. That's all it should take. It's just that time. So don't pick things that are super time consuming. These are those, you know, many of you are building foundational pieces. So you'll need that 3 hour block of time for that. That 3 hour block of time is independent of these little daily ones. Okay. So I think that's another key part. That 3 hours is to be able to fix up all the stuff you might be behind on, or the things that you have to chunk in to make big progress. Those are moving hours. Those 3 hours are to move you forward. And you can think of my big eyes going, move you forward, right? Move you forward. The other thing that we're going to talk about is lead and lag. And that is its own gem. And it's really a conceptual goal. So when you're thinking about the conceptual goal, a lead is like, what am I doing right now? And a lag is just the outcome. So if we were going back to, right, move goals every day, maybe eat three vegetables in a day, I gave myself, I couldn't do three vegetables, so I started with fruits and vegetables, right? Change my tactic. I found out I didn't have as many vegetables to love as I needed. So I had to go back to do that. That I'm like, I need to fall in love with more vegetables. So I had to change my tactic. And I had to go, okay, how can I cook vegetables in a way that are just yummy and make me crave them, right? That's a tactic. So just writing it the first time, I couldn't do it. And so you'll find that's the point of tactics, is that you're changing them so you can get to where you have to go. Because if we all knew how to do our stuff, we'd all have it done. And we don't. And so what I learned is that when I found a way to make gingered carrots, I will make them for you. They are amazing. When I learned how to make vegetables in a way that was really great, I could do it. And random tip, my friends that are from Africa, they gave me a little tip on vegetables because I eat vegetables at their house. And theirs are always better than mine. And my friend Mary just said, oh, well, let me show you how Africans make them. And she drizzles a little bit of honey and then serves them. Changed it. She's like, you have to sweeten the pot. Mm. Now that really made me understand what sweeten the pot meant, right? So you have to change your tactics. And that's why you do the scorecard every week. That's why you do the review. There's a review in here. This reflection every week that I have to reflect to see, do I even like the tactic that I picked? I don't know. So we going back to, I backstepped, but so now you're going to see lead and lag, right? Lag is like, what's the outcome? So like, I wanted to lose weight or I wanted this other thing, right? That's the outcome. We won't know that. We're looking for leading things, things that will automatically lead me to the outcome that I want. And lag is something that's already been done. It's in your rear view mirror. So many of you are putting a goal on that's actually what you want to see in your rear view mirror. So you might want to lose 5 pounds, or you may want to have a project finished or whatever. That's a lag indicator. And that's just a business term. So we all do that when we're measuring productivity. So that it's just business language. So if you didn't know what those mean, that it's not going to harm you in how you're going to get forward. That it is just a business term and you see it a lot in corporate. So that's a very corporate measury thing. But you're looking for lead things, things that lead the way to the route for you, right? I kind of find where this comes in on the thing, but anyway, the route for you. Right. We're looking for the route for you. That's why we put so many tactics up. So if you got the tactic PDF book that we made, that's why we made so many of them, that not to overwhelm you and make you crazy, but to go, oh, well, here's what some tactics look like. let me find the one that works for me, or let me reword. You know, sometimes looking at the tactics that other people do, it just gives you a way to go, okay, I'm just going to reword this for me. And you should, because your life is very different. And the things that you want for your outcome are very different than what other people have. We have lots of people in here who are in sales, who are in achieving, who are self-employed, who have very big goals. And we also have people in here who are retired and want to bring more definition to their free time, and people who are trying to find themselves again, who are on a journey of self-discovery. That it's every kind of person. That's what I love about it. And I love that it's people from all over the country. So you have every socioeconomic group. You have people that are super wealthy and super not wealthy. You have people that are every color, every nationality. They're from everywhere in the world. And they have a very unique outlook. And they all have the same thing in common, which is, right, that everyone is trying to hold, right, the self and esteem so that they can keep the promises to themselves. And they're learning how to do that in an execution system. We must do the work every day. And so these are just tools to help you along the way. So again, right, thank you. Thank you. Thank you for sharing your Sundays with me. Thank you for watching the video. Thank you for thinking about what you're doing, because I have a belief. I have a personal bias on you. And the personal bias is that the more that you do the things that make you magic, the more magic will be around you. And that feels really good to me. And that feels really good for my community. And that's why I show up. That's, you know, look, a $10 class isn't going to change, like, it's not going to change anybody's life. But a $10 class every Saturday that supports you on being you and that you can do over and over again, now that's powerful. That's powerful. And to do that, you and I both have to commit to saying, let's talk about it. Let's look at what's foundational and vital for your life. And let's look at the capital that you have. Let's build a route. Let's see what's there. Let's test some stuff out. Let's throw some stuff out. Let's celebrate when you're doing well. Let's pick you up when you're feeling kind of grumbly, because that's what an accountability group is in Prosperity Mindset. It is a group of people that will surround and love you as you move forward. And I do trust your ability to know what's right for you. And out of 25 years of doing kind of business stuff, most people know the right answer for them. And so your life isn't going to be that different. You know what direction you should be going. But it's, do you have the grit, right, to stay on it? Well, nobody does. So that's why you have group. That's why you need to show up. That's why you have to put that time in your calendar too. And that time in your calendar, what I like about that is that I believe that's grace. Right? Let me just show up. Let me hear what everybody else is doing, and let me bring my kind thoughts to myself and to everyone else in that group. And that usually works. So I hope to see you in class. If you are overwhelmed, remember, right, it's just that you are unrouted, that we've got to find the route for you. As soon as we find that route, you're going to be just fine. You're going to be just fine. It's now like 75 days. So you've got time. It's going to go quick. And then you'll be watching this again after you've already completed one. That'll be great. All right. I will see you in group. Bye.